underestimate the power of the Force.
I am a shadowy reflection of you.
You don't believe me?
I need that baby alive.
We will take what we wish.
He will join us or die.
Oh. There is no escape.
You may fire when ready.
Kill them!
Shoot them.
Kill her.
Terminate her.
Enough, she dies!
I will not turn, and you'll be forced to kill me.
Courage, Willow.
The Force will be with you.
Trust me.
Count me in.
I'm going to fight.
I'm not afraid.
I won't let you kill that child.
Here we go again. Let's go!
Punch it!
Don't get...
The Lucasfilm Home THX audio system was developed to bring to the home the same high-quality sound presentation that has set the standard in the motion picture industry. Both the professional THX system and now Home THX were developed by teams headed by Tomlinson Holman, corporate technical director for Lucasfilm.
Our goals were to make sound systems which could recreate the sound experience exactly the way the filmmaker intended.
You are experiencing the Home THX audio system. The THX system was designed for movie theaters to reproduce sound precisely the way it was created in the sound studio. Today, the same high standards of quality have been brought from the theater into the home. To better appreciate the concept of THX, let's take a look at how a film soundtrack is created. The final soundtrack of a motion picture is created after the movie has been filmed. What you are hearing is the original recording made on the set.
Okay, look up.
Look up, gents.
Coming up above you. Okay, look at the door.
This production sound is often incomplete and of poor quality. Dialogue is often drowned out by the noises on the set. Sound effects needed to create a sense of realism are missing.
This ship carries the crest of Aldrin. With any of the royal family on board?
Often a voice is temporary and will be replaced later by another actor.
Start tearing the ship apart. You find those things. Find the passengers of this vessel. I want them alive!
Dialogue may be missing altogether. In this scene, the director speaks R2-D2's lines.
You were lucky to get out of there. Anything broken?
Scenes involving miniatures and animation have no production sound. The hundreds of sounds that a scene like this requires must be created back in the sound studio. To understand the process, let's follow step by step how the soundtrack for this scene is put together. First, we analyze the production sound. This is what it sounded like on the set.
Small world, Dr. Jones.
Too small for two of us.
Oh.
This is the second time I've had to reclaim my property from you.
It belongs in a museum.
So do you. I'm over the side!
Because of the noise made by the machines used to create the wind and waves, this production sound is useful only as a guide. It will take the fabrication of new dialogue, sound effects, and music to complete the scene. The first step is to re-record the dialogue.
Small world, Dr. Jones.
Too small for two of us.
The actors are brought into the sound studio. While watching the scene projected, they record their words again, in sync with the original dialogue.
This is the second time I've had to reclaim my property from you.
That belongs in a museum.
So do you. Throw him over the side.
This process is called looping, or ADR, Automated Dialogue Replacement. Now the addition of the sound effects begins. The sounds are organized into layers, groups of similar sound that, for creative flexibility, are kept on separate tracks. This layer is made up of footsteps, prop handling, and body movement. It is called Foley. These effects are best achieved by performing the sound while watching the picture. This way, timings and textures can be fine-tuned and perfected.